Hello, my name is Pepijn. Since we're stuck at home, I decided to make a video series for my fellow students about archaeological material that you can find on the surface here in the Netherlands, but also can use to or recognize in archaeological context. In this pilot episode, we'll start with clay pipes, simply because it's a common and easy to identify find here in the Netherlands, but also the rest of the world. And that's because they widely traded during colonial times. Now, tobacco comes from the Americas, as well as the concept of pipe smoking. And therefore, pipe making is introduced to Europe and England, England and the Netherlands in the late 16th century, around 1580. Then the industry of both countries quickly pick up, and it also starts in the rest of Europe. And because of these, because they start to be mass produced, and you can use them as guide fossils, and they break very easily, as you can see that this stem is very fragile, so they're really a short-term product. And that means that you can date these or most of these pipes to about 10 years precisely, which makes a very good guide fossil. Now the general trend for dating these pipes is that the bowl of the pipe is usually smaller first and become bigger over time, and the stem is thicker and becomes thinner. So as here you can see the thicker stem, more of the remnants of the 17th century, and one stem from the 19th century. And this pipe here, I made the timeline, comes from the 1640s, plus minus 10 years of course. This one is from the start of the 18th century. And this one is from the early 20th century. Now, most of these pipes are undecorated, but you can find them fully decorated. This is only slightly less common though, but it becomes more common from the 18th century onward. Here you have an example of a bug, a horse with a crown on it. This is a decoration called a lobben. I don't know if there's an English term for it, but it's the Dutch term used. And also, which is very nice to know, is that these clay pipes contain makers marks, usually on the heel of the pipe, in which you can identify the pipe maker and the city where he's from. So it gives an extra amount of information, which is fun to look up, and there are great way, great sources where you can look these up. Now, the earliest pipes are very small, and when they were rediscovered, and I'm mainly talking about the ones from the 16th century, they were called fairy pipes. As they were so tiny, they thought no people could have smoked them, so they must have been smoked by fairies. This is mainly an English story, but it's fun to know. Most of these pipes are made out of white clay, the so-called pijpaarden in Dutch. But you can also find them in other colors like red and black, but these are less common. And what you may have noticed during this video, that the complete pipe here has a very, very long stem. This was actually for the most period that these were produced very common, and later on they made also shorter stems, so this is more in the line of the late 19th and early 20th century. But because these stems are very long, they easily break, so you usually find the bowl without a piece of stem on it. I hope you like this video. I like to shoot more videos, but I'll first see how this one does. So I would like to say goodbye, and I hope to see you in the next video.